What's up guys, welcome to another video. Today we're going to create a 3D platformer game in Gdevelop. To follow along with this example, I download this file from the forum. There is a link down in the description below. Okay, so let's see what we have in this file. So if I run this now, you'll notice that this is just a regular platform game. Okay, we have been working on this for some time now. Maybe we can, let me just make this bigger. So we have more ground to walk on. There we go. So this is the example file. Let me show you the, let me show you what we're making today. Let me just save this. This is what our game is going to look like after we finish this video. This is what we're making today. We are making a 3D platformer. Whoa. It's a jumping worm in a 3D world. Wow, I almost fell that time. I don't think I can make that jump. Maybe I can. Oh yes, I can. There we go. Yeah, this is the same worm we have been working on. Except for this time, it's running in a 3D world. Whoa. Okay, so open your example file and let's get started. Now if you look under events, you can see that this is just a regular platform controller. Okay, we have been working on this in the past few videos. So we're gonna make this into 3D. Yeah, let's right click and let's insert a new object. This time we're going to need a 3D box. You have to enable this. And this will give us this here. So let's click on the image bank editor. I'm gonna make this bigger. So we're gonna import the texture for the bricks. There's our texture. Let's put this in the front, back, bottom, left, right, and back. And let's hit OK. Actually, let's make the depth maybe 100. Okay, so maybe 100 was a little too much. Let me make this maybe 80. Now if you run this now, you'll notice that nothing happens except for the worm falls into empty space. So let's make our 3D object a platform object. Let's add a behavior and let's make this a platform. Let's run this. And you can see that this works right away. Disable the grid and let's make this bigger. Let's set this up to -30. Try it out. I'm gonna make sure this is set to 0, the order. And this one is at, let's make this 20, so it will be above everything else. Let's play it. And that sort of works already. Maybe we can push this in a little bit more. Let's try -40. And that seems a little better. Sure, now all we have to do is copy this brick. And we're gonna paste it. You can do it freehand or you can use the grid. Paste another one. Another one. That's the beginning of the level. We're gonna go down. That's the end of the level. Let's play this and we can't get out this way. See how let's jump. And you can see that this is a a 3D game. Whoa. I think I made that too high. So there you go, that's how you can create a 3D platformer in Gdevelop. Alright, so don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.